of candles can be lighted from a single candle, and the life of the candle will not shorten. Happiness never decreases by being shared. And so, before we start today's journey, I would request you all to smile, to show the excitement of this new day on your faces. Thank you all.
Our first speaker for the day is Lieutenant General Noble Thamburaj, PVSM, SM, former Vice Chief of Army Staff and patron of IIEBM Indus Business School, Pune. Sir, may I have your permission to begin, please? Thank you, sir. Sir was commissioned into the Bombay Sappers on 15th June 1969. He is a graduate from the NDA Khadakwasla and IMA Dehradun. He is also accredited with higher technical qualifications like M.Tech, Building Science from IIT Delhi and M.Phil Defence Studies from Indore University and M.Sc. from Madras University. During his illustrious career, the General has held many important assignments to include a Brigade Major of Mountain Brigade, Command of 411 Independent Field Para Company, 109 Rapid S Engineer Regiment, a Rashtriya Rifle Sector during Operation Vijay, and an Infantry Division during Operation Parakram.
The General has also seen action during Indo-Pak War in 1971 and counter-insurgency operations in Northeast and Jammu and Kashmir. He also holds a unique distinction of being the only sapper officer to have commanded RR Sector. He has been an instructor in OTH Chennai and Defence Services Staff College, Wellington. On promotion to the rank of Major General, he assumed the coveted appointment of GOC 11 Infantry Division on 16 December 2002, looking after the defence of Gujarat, specially Run of Kutch. And in May 2006, he took over as GOC 11 Corps. On promotion to the rank of Lieutenant General, the officer was decorated with Sena Medal during his command for 8th Sector RR in Kupwara in Punjab. In recognition of his exemplary devotion to duty and for displaying exceptional wisdom while planning, organizing and execution operations. Now, I request sir to please guide the badge with his words of wisdom.
Ashura, thank you for all the good words, kind words that you spoke. Professor Jai Singh, the Managing Director of the College, Dr. Govind, Indrapal, members of faculty and students of the 19th batch. Jai Hind and a good morning to all of you. I also take this opportunity to welcome the new batch to this college, and it is my honor to speak to you on your second day of induction training. This day, today, which is your second day of induction, I feel is all about you. It is not about the speakers, it is not about the faculty, but it is all about you individually. You guys who have left the comforts of your home, the protected umbrella of your families, and you have come to this college to become something in life. So you guys have sacrificed something very important to you, and you have come here to become members of another extended family. And by this process, I am sure each one of you will become something in life. There are some days in our lives which are special. And today, I'm sure, is one of those special days in each one of your lives. I have no doubt that early this morning, as you were getting ready to come to the college, there must have been some apprehensions in your mind. There might have been certain nervousness. There would have been certain tingling in your stomachs. There would have been questions which would have come to your mind as to how is going to be my day. Who are going to be my teachers, professors? What would the college be like? What would be my friends or classmates be like? So this excitement which is there within you, it's like a spark. And it is this spark of excitement which keeps us alive. It is this spark which makes us energetic, which makes us enthusiastic, and it keeps us alive. And last, it makes us happy. I don't know if you guys have seen movies which are about 10 years old. There was a movie called Jab We Met. Has anyone seen that movie? Who is the heroine of that movie? Can you imagine, in the first half of the movie, if I say she had a spark in her belly and her behavior, how would you describe her? Yes, this young lady in front of me.
Excitement.
Okay, this lady with the hands up.
Jovial.
Anyone else? Enthusiastic, positive mind.
Practical about life.
No, she was impractical about life, I think, no? Yeah, but you are on the right lines. So that is what. So I wouldn't be wrong in saying, when I say spark in your belly, I think my eyes always picture Kareena Kapoor in Jab We Met, especially the first half of the film. Correct? So that is the kind of excitement, that is what the spark does to you. I would like to believe that this spark is like a flame of a candle. And it is our job to keep that flame burning. How does a mother keep a young child or baby alive? In English, there's a word called nurturing. The mother nurtures the child, protects the child. You know? So you got to nurture that flame which is in your belly. And most important, you got to ensure that the flame or the spark is burning. Because believe me, once that spark goes off, if the flame is extinguished, it is very, very difficult to reignite it again. Now I take your mind to the second half of the movie, Jab We Met. I don't think she was that energetic, because at some stage that spark in her belly had got extinguished. So there are some people in whom the spark has faded or the spark has gone off. Can you picture some people like this? No, you meet such guys, retired guys, aimlessly walking on the road, finding faults with everybody. They are dejected. They are aimless. They are dull. And they are bitter. I'm sure you've come across such people in your life. So you do want to become like Kareena Kapoor, or do you want to become like these guys without a spark in their belly? Kareena Kapoor. Okay. Boys say, we don't want to become Kareena Kapoor, we want to be with Kareena Kapoor. Am I right? Okay, yes, somebody from there has said yes. So my first advice to you this morning is, please keep the spark in you alive. So just note, first advice number one, keep the spark within you alive. More about the spark later in the talk. I think there are some gloomy faces in that corner because they've got some seniors walking up and down, so those guys are very, very gloomy and looking down. What happened? Didn't get breakfast? The last benches? Why aren't you smiling? I heard one of the seniors say smile. All of you please smile. Not good enough. Like this. Ha 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 ha. That's better. So, this is addressed to the back benches. A few years back, a Pakistani diplomat was posted to New York, to the United Nations. So as happens there, these guys are allowed to take their families. And this chap had a 5-year-old son. So this kid gets admitted to a school, and the first day happens like this. So when the kid in class, you know, I don't know, because my grandchildren also in America, when they were young, I used to take them to the school. So these American young women who are the teachers, they have great pride in their flag. And they have great pride in everybody saying that we are Americans. Right? Today, I think Trump has turned that theory upside down, but those days, they wanted everyone in America to say we are Americans. So as the attendance is taken, she asked this guy, what is your name? And this chap says, my name is Mohammed. I'm 5 years old and I'm from Pakistan. So this maybe 20 something lady teacher tells him, no, from now on, your name will be Johnny and you are an American and you remain 5 years old. Agreed? So he's very happy. So by the end of the day, all the kids call him Johnny. Now this guy at the end of the day goes back and his mother asks him, how was your day? She says, he replies to his mother, I'm not Mohammed, my name is Johnny and I'm American. So the, like a good Pakistani mother, she gives him 2 tight slaps. She says, no, imagine our culture, we are the best culture, best religion, how can you do this? Yeah. So she's very angry and upset. So when the dad comes home, she complains, the first thing is, see, I told you not to come to America. Now this guy is, ask him, he tells his dad, I'm not a Pakistani, I'm an American, because my ma'am mistold me, and my name is Johnny. So as a good Pakistani father, he kicks him also, hits him and keeps hitting him. And this chap keeps saying, no, I'm American. So till he says, I'm Pakistani, he doesn't leave him. So next morning when this youngster comes to school, the teacher asks him, what happened? You're black eye, bruised. She says, miss, 5 hours after I became an American, I was attacked by 2 Pakis. I was beaten and assaulted by 2 Pakis. Now at least you guys are smiling or no? Yeah, that's better. So, my daughter, when I last went, she was angry with my grandson, so she called him ABCD. So I said, what is ABCD? Does anybody know what is ABCD? She said, American born, confused Desi. So maybe this Johnny was also American-born, confused Pakistani. Okay. So my second advice to you is, keep smiling. Be cheerful. I have been in a number of senior appointments, and you'll know that whether in the corporate or whether in the army or whatever walk of life, or your own parents, grandparents, why do they like to play with grandchildren? It's because they like people who are cheerful and smiling. So if you want your boss in your company to like you, please be cheerful. Right? Believe me that your superiors will always prefer to be surrounded by cheerful guys who are known today as the sunshine people. People who bring sunshine into the room when you walk in. So don't be serious, but be sincere. You know, serious are the guys who'll, you know, there was a movie called Three Idiots. Who was the serious guy? Who? Raju. Chatur. Who? Chatur, isn't it? So he was the serious guy. Who was the sincere guy? Rancho, no? Yeah. So that's the difference. So I've given you two advice. Number one is, keep the spark burning. Second is, be cheerful. Be like Rancho, not like Mr. Chatur. I think Chatur came from my part of the country. He was also smart in his own way. Positive attitude, hard work and team spirit. Any of you heard of a guy called Shiv Khera? Really? I didn't hear of him till I was 45 years. You guys are very smart. So this guy, who is he? He's a movie actor. He's a management guru. Correct? So this chap, in his book, one of the books, he says that he has interviewed the top industrialists. And he asked these top guys in the corporate, when you pick up a chap, what are you looking at? The single most important quality. And you'll be surprised by the answer. The top corporate guys in India, they all said that they're looking for guys with the right attitude. They're not looking for IIT Ahmedabad. They're not looking for guys from IIT Delhi. But they're looking for guys with the right attitude. So they say it is the right attitude which makes all the difference. They're not looking at machine, they're not looking at computers, they're not looking at resources, they're looking at manpower. So again, I take you back to a movie called Three Idiots. Who had the right attitude? But later on, even the other two guys had good attitude, no? The chap who was doing, what was he, a guy was a photographer, isn't it? So the right attitude, opportunity, you see, that guy qualified himself as by working under some good wildlife photographer, he became himself very good. So it takes time. So you guys got to pick up, both boys and girls here, you got to pick up. Don't keep thinking of, you know, Mahatma Gandhi and Sardar Patel and all. In your organization, you start looking at people. Like the seniors, superiors assess you, you also look up and who are the good chaps in your company. Right? And you identify, okay, A, B, C. You start learning from them. So like seniors adopt juniors, juniors should also adopt some senior and, you know, spend time with them, learn, because you'll gain knowledge from them. The next point I have is multitasking. Multitasking is the capability of doing two or three tasks together. In India, who has on the cricket field guys who can multitask? What are they called?
All-rounders.
So in T20, who are the guys who get the maximum money? Bloody Yusuf Pathan. Who is the other all-rounder? Some Hardik Pandya. There's another chap, Jadeja. Sunil Narayan. So you know these guys who are all-rounders get the maximum money, 10 crores. What are they doing? Multitasking. If you look in your family, who's the one who's multitasking? I think, are you on the first day or the last day of the course? Second day. So women can multitask. You'll find that in the office, you'll find that at home. You know, you're nursing a child, you're making lunch, you're suddenly doing homework for the other kid. Right? And men can do only one task at a time. If he's watching soccer, maximum you can do is eat popcorn along with it. But you can't do anything else apart from watching the World Cup match. See the difference? So we must, in your organization, try and be a multitasker. You can't say, you have given me this job. I think these days in management they call it roles. You have given me a role of this, I will only do this job. No. Be a multitasker. So you've got to make yourself capable. So in all these things I have explained, you have to be capable. So now let's go back to the spark. Remember we spoke about a spark long time back? Let's go back. So I said, like a mother, we need to nurture that spark which is in our belly. In other words, we got to keep the flame burning. Today, you might be in your 20s, you got a spark. Even at the age of 40, 45, the spark should be burning. So what does a mother do? She nurtures. Whether it's a mother elephant, mother anyone, they nurture their children till they are independent. And secondly, we need to protect. I told you the spark is like a flame of a candle. It's delicate. So we got to protect that flame. Right? Flame is to be protected from storms. It has to be protected from wind. Now, nurturing is like, how do you nurture? A mother, what does she do? She motivates the child into speaking one word, then two words. She wants the child to take one step, you know, recognize people. And slowly as a child, she tells her what is bad, what is good. So this is guidance, is nurturing. So how does she do it? By setting goals. Take one step. Okay, take two steps. By setting goals, you nurture. So you also got to set these simple goals for ourselves in our lives. Set targets for yourself which you can meet. Because if you keep failing again and again in meeting your targets, the flame will die. So you got to nurture your flame by setting targets for yourself and achieving those targets. My next point is, why are rich countries rich and poor countries poor? Somebody without specs, because all the right answers are being given by guys with specs. Why are rich countries rich? Oh, you know that girl, young lady at the back. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, who raised your hand?
Good morning. My name is Neha Patil and I'm from Nasik, Maharashtra.
Okay, wine country.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, rich countries are rich because of the infrastructure they are having.
Okay.
And there are some kind of partiality over there. The gap between the rich and the poor are wider over there in the developed countries as compared to developing countries. The infrastructure are very poor in developing countries. So this is the richer. Riches are becoming richer and poor are becoming poorer.
Okay. So you've given the thing, but symptoms, but not. But let me put it in a different way. I read this article a long time back, so it amazed me. It said countries are not rich because the age of the nation. Because Egypt is 4,000 years old, I mean, give or take 1,000 years. India is again 4,000 years old. And both are counted as not rich countries, poor countries. Whereas New Zealand, Canada, Australia are just 150 years old. But they are rich. It is not due to natural resources. A country without any natural resource is Japan. And whatever is the land available, 80% of that is very high mountains and volcanoes. So it is unsuitable for agriculture. But Japan, imagine, is like a floating factory. You know, on the sea, they're just factories. They import raw material and export finished goods. Switzerland, it does not grow cocoa. I mean, Switzerland is famous for chocolates. Anyone had Swiss chocolates? Very good. Better than Indian chocolates? Okay. Chocolate is made of cocoa, right? And Switzerland does not grow cocoa, but makes the best chocolates. Cultivation for only 4 months. So you'll see a lot of animals, cows there, they get the best milk products. On the other hand, you see executives. Whether you're from a rich country or from a poor country, there's not much difference. You know, the top American companies are being run by Indians. So you can't say Indian MBAs are bad because they are successful in America. Does it depend on race or color of your skin? No? To some extent? No? Okay. Not at all. So migrants from so-called lazy countries, when they go to Europe and America, start working very hard. Right? So again, it's not because of hard work also. So on the other hand, what a lot of people say that countries are poor because of the attitude. Remember what the top corporate guy said? We are looking at people with the right attitude. So collective attitude is what we lack. We like to cut corners. If you go to America, just nobody will jump a red light. Nobody will jump the speed. You know, small rules which are there, they will not cut corners. And we want to get results, take advantage of everybody and everything. Thank you. Enjoyed?
Yes, sir.
All the best. I had fun interacting with you. And, you know, as part of the spark this thing, you must take life as it comes. Don't become too serious. Like that Chatur character. Don't become. You know, there will be lot of pressure on you to this thing, but some disappointments, just laugh it out. And it's only after retirement that we become smart, because if I have any problem, I just start playing with my grandchildren. So there will be some support system which you have to build around you. You may have your best friend, you may have your husband or wife, you may have some, you know, some other relative. This Lukaku character, his support system was his grandfather sitting in Congo. So everybody has this, you've got to build some sort of a support system who really support you, right? It may be your friends, it may be anybody, and sometimes it may be your superiors. Your superiors are human beings, they are also good guys. Every superior is not a bad guy. You know, there's a story which I was reading the other day, that there was a security guard, you know, he would keep wishing that owner of that house, rich guy, good morning, good evening. That chap never answered. But that owner saw him picking up some food from the garbage. So after that, that owner, rich man, started keeping a package of fresh vegetables and groceries and he used to watch from his window, this guy would come and pick up that. So he kept doing it for many years. So when he died, obviously that packet was not there. So this, when he, that lady of the house, when she, he went and told her, you are the seventh guy who has come and said that this chap has been leaving food packets around every day. And then in conversation he learned that this chap was hard of hearing. That is why when he said good morning, that chap never heard good morning and he never wished him. See? So sometimes your bosses can be good also. So you can have a support system of your boss. Need not always be family. Thanks a lot. I had good fun. And I'm sure Professor Jai Singh is going to offer me a good cup of coffee. Thank you very much.
Sir, it cannot be explained in words how excited we are after listening to you. We are indeed very lucky to have you here with us. Thank you so much, sir.
Here, we have a 5 minutes break. Be back soon.